Hey, what is up, guys? Welcome to AXT. And do you remember how Microsoft said that there will be no Windows after Windows 10? And Windows 10 will be the last version of the Windows ever. Microsoft was working on this Windows 10X project secretly, and they stopped the project too, entirely. Well, that's not the thing now. Microsoft has announced the Windows 11 on their yearly event, which was on 24th of June 2021. And of course, you can get the beta version through the Windows Insider program. A point to be noticed, a lot of people quickly realized that their PC might not meet the minimum requirement of the Windows 11. Right after checking the Windows 11 compatibility with their PC health checker, which Microsoft is providing on their website, most of them will meet every requirements that Windows 11 wants, just except one component, and that's the TPM 2.0, Trusted Platform Module 2.0. You can check the version of your TPM by searching tpm.msc on the start. In my case, my laptop is really old, like it was from 2014 to 2015. So when I check that, it doesn't has any TPM on it. Also, it doesn't has secure boot. And I got the same error, like your PC will not run Windows 11. But if your PC is like Shweta, she has the TPM version 2.0, it will show something like this. Maybe this is not the end of the story for you, because you can still try some of the things that you haven't tried. Maybe the TPM is available on your PC, but it is disabled. You can go ahead and check in the BIOS. But before all that things, let's get to know what TPM is actually. Wikipedia says, Trusted Platform Module is an international standard for a secure crypto processor, a dedicated microcontroller designed to secure hardware through integrated cryptographic keys. In simple words, it's a microcontroller which is totally isolated from your computer. This isolated chip sitting on your computer does cryptographic functions like storing keys or storing digital fingerprints, or does authorization and all that stuff. Or sometimes it is used to encrypt your hard drive. Its role has become more vital as cyber threats continue to target the lowest level of system operation, including the master boot record, system firmware, and operating file systems. A dedicated cryptographic microprocessor processes key data and verifies the integrity of low-level system assets like boot files and system firmware. If a change is detected, TPM stops that compromised file or software to run and halts the attack before it can start. You probably heard of two types of TPM, TPM 1.2 and TPM 2.0. TPM 1.2 is obviously the older version, and TPM 2.0 is the newest one. TPM 1.2 was released on March 3 of 2011, and whereas this TPM 2.0 was released on around October 2014, and its latest edition and errata was released in 2019. Well, you see, these things are not new. These are old. And unknowingly, you might have these things on your BIOS. Meanwhile, I read some forums. Microsoft says that TPM 2.0 is industry standard. It's not just anything that Microsoft follows. Also, on the other hand, if you see Apple has never introduced the TPM 2.0 on the Intel Macs. So none of the Apple Macs is compatible with the Windows 11. Here is the interesting thing. There are two types of TPM. One is DTPM and FTPM. DTPM stands for Discrete TPM, Trusted Platform Module, and FTPM is the Firmware TPM. DTPM is actually a discrete chip, discrete physical chip which can be fitted on the motherboard, and it comes both in 1.2 and 2.0. On the other hand, FTPM means it can be inside a processor a certain section of the processor which handles the function of TPM, and it doesn't have to be a physical chip on your motherboard. Intel adopted this technology and they specially named it as PTT, Platform Trust Technology. Intel's PTT was first introduced on 2013, with the fourth generation Intel processors and the chipsets, including the Intel Haswell on the U and Y series. But it's quite amusing that my laptop has i5 fourth generation Haswell 4200U, which is actually Haswell and it is from the U series. But surprisingly, it doesn't have any TPM on it, but it should have. Intel actually didn't take this feature as a standard for all their chips, but I think they properly implemented this thing from 2018 to all their new chips. On the other hand, AMD also has the same story. They implemented this feature on their APU's APU, the processor with the graphics on it. They just added this FTPM and they just call it FTPM instead of giving any fancy names. To make it more simple, if you don't want to go to all the hassle, then let me tell you that the PC which were made after 2018, it definitely has the FTPM built on it as a standard. Both applies to AMD and AMD CPU and Intel CPUs both. So if your CPU is manufactured after 2018, then you probably are in the safe zone. And yeah, if you have FTPM, then you don't need a physical chip TPM 2.0 on your motherboard. What if you later on find out that your CPU does actually support TPM or FTPM? Then all you need to do is just open up your UEFI BIOS, go to the advanced tab, and if you have an Intel processor, then it will definitely be written as PTT, and if you have AMD, then it will just show up FTPM or AMD platform security processor. So what if you don't have FTPM? It depends if you have a laptop or a desktop. If you have a laptop, then I must say, my friends, I'm really sorry. There's nothing you can do. You just have to upgrade into a new laptop. And if you have a desktop, there are still chances that you have a certain place on your motherboard to connect that chip, TPM 2.0. You can just open up your motherboard manual and search it up. If they mentioned where is the TPM chip connector. If you got one, then that's a good thing, but that's not the end of the story there. You'll have to know if your motherboard supports TPM 1.2 or 2.0. It's not backward compatible. Like, if your motherboard supports only 1.2, then you gotta put 1.2. And if it supports 2.0, then you need to put 2.0. But if it happens to be supporting both of them, then it's hunky-dory. Also, point to be noted, it comes in two variants. Those chips actually comes in two variants, 14 pins and 20 pins. So you better check them out. For example, if you have a Asus motherboard, then it may not support the HP's TPM chip. It may only support Asus TPM chip. So ultimately you face the final challenge that your laptop doesn't support FTPM, doesn't has FTPM, or your PC doesn't support TPM 2.0, or it may have 1.2. So I hate to say it, my friend, but Windows 11 is not going to run on your PC until and unless Microsoft will lower the requirements of the Windows 11. But still, you know, you'll be getting the Windows 10 updates and you can run through it. But if you are still too desperate to get the Windows 11, then you have no choice. You will have to upgrade your hardware itself. You have to get a new PC like the Microsoft says. But also there are some fishy ways, like you have to replace the Windows 11's files with the Windows 10. If you do that, the Windows 11 won't search for the TPM 2.0. But if I teach that in this video, this will lead to the Windows piracy, rise of Windows piracy. So I think that's it. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. And if you found this video informative and if somehow this video helped you, then feel free to leave a like below the subscribe button. And until then, see you guys in the next one.